Hi, this is Larry Jordan. This is an excerpt of a recent power-up webinar called Ask Larry Anything, where I get to answer questions from viewers. For instance, this one. Reinhardt, what is the recommended setting in Final Cut 10 or compressor to export a master copy of the finished movie? Well, you can't do... Master copies are always high-quality uncompressed. You would create the master file inside Final Cut. The way you do that is you select the video that you want to output, go up to File, go down to Share, and select Master File. So that's how you get there. Then, once you open up the Share dialog, this is just where you add your info. Under Settings, you want to export this, a video codec of Apple ProRes 422. This is a really good balance between extremely, extremely high quality, which is up around 422 and 444, with a reasonable file size. Unless you're working with really high-grade equipment and you're working with really high-quality lenses, you're not going to see a difference between 422 HQ and 422. The only difference between these two is the data rate. Also movement. If you've got something that's moving a lot, think of a dance piece. 422 HQ will probably look better. Under audio, you want to have the audio file format. In this case, there none means that it's uncompressed. By the way, you'll notice, and for those of you that read my newsletter last week, you'll notice that there's no keyboard shortcut that says Master File Command E. I thought it had gone missing. It's actually been moved to a preference file. I'm going to write about this in my newsletter. If I click on Master File and make this the default, now this changed with the 10.08 release. If I make this the default, notice it now says default. I clicked on it, I right mouse clicked on it, and I said make default. Now when you close this and go back to File, Share, Master File now has the Command E associated with it. Master File was the default in versions prior to 10.08. With 10.08, they made it a preference setting, and I wasn't paying attention. So we're going to have to write about this and apologize to the 752,000 people that wrote to say that I was wrong in last week's newsletter. I'll deal with that in this week's newsletter. This was an excerpt of a recent power-up webinar called Ask Larry Anything. For a complete list of all of our online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. Oh, by the way, membership is a great value. If you need to stretch your training dollars, a subscription membership to our video training library saves you money. You can access all of our videos for a low monthly price of only $19.99. That's more than 500 movies, dozens of hours of training, all in-depth and up-to-date. Plus, members can attend all of our power-up webinars for free. Our training covers Apple and Adobe software. We update it every week. And for more information, visit larryjordan.biz/subscriptions. Thanks.